Hello, in this video, I will discuss about whale optimization algorithm. Topics covered in this video: what is this algorithm all about and its mathematical model. Let's start this with short introduction about whale. As we all know, whale is the largest animal on earth. And we have different whale species like killer whale, finback, humpback, and blue whales. We have few facts about whales. They never sleep, they live alone or in groups. Killer whales can live in family. Now we have a question, what they eat? Their diet is krills or fish. Biggest baleen whale length is 12 to 16 meter long and weight is about 25 to 30 ton. This algorithm, that is whale optimization algorithm, is inspired by the hunting technique used by humpback whale. So in this video, we will learn about humpback whale and their hunting strategy. Next question is, what is humpback whale? Something like this. So this is humpback whale. An adult humpback whale is almost a size of school bus. And what they eat? Krills and small fishes. Now, what is krill? Krill is an individual who live in deep ocean. Now, we will learn the hunting strategy used by humpback whale, as this algorithm is inspired by their hunting behavior. So, first, we have a humpback whale. And so, once the prey is discovered, so first task is, we will discover the target. As you can see here, we have sea, humpback whale and the prey. So once the target is discovered, humpback whale dive 12 meter deep in the sea. And you can see here, humpback whale create bubble nets to catch their prey. This method that is used by humpback whale is known as bubble net feeding method. So this is the hunting strategy that is used by humpback whale to capture their prey. First, they will find the target. After that, they will dive 12 meter deep, and you can see now they will create the bubble net around the target. So how they can create this net? Humpback whale blow bubbles underwater, and you can see here they are creating a net of bubbles around the target. And you can see here target is now captured and they can eat. So this is the simple strategy that is used by humpback whale to capture their target. So we have different phases. First, search for the target, encircle it, and attack. In real life, this is natural. It is done by whale. They will search for the target, encircle them by using this method, and attack. Now, to represent this situation, we will use mathematical model. So author used here different mathematical models to represent this behavior of humpback whale. First, we have mathematical model to search for the prey, for searching. After that, mathematical model for encircling and hunting. So this is about how prey is searched. So this is about searching. We are using here coefficient vector A and we will assign a random value to this. We are using this vector to search for the prey, and the random value is assigned here. Then we will check if this value is greater than 1 or not. You can see here, this is the reference individual, and here we have the new individual, and you can see the value of A updated here. So we will check the value of A. If the value of A is greater than 1, it means the new individual is far away. We are using here this in order to search for the prey. As you can see here, if value is greater, it means the individual is far away. And here you can see A and C are the coefficient vectors. R is the random value and T is the current iteration and max T is the maximum iteration. D is the distance vector. X is the position. R is the random values. Here we are using this for the searching. After that, you can see here for hunting, they are using bubble net feeding method and they can recognize their prey and encircle them. And the best candidate, we will consider the best candidate among all as the target prey. Once the search agent is defined, other search agent will update their position toward the best search agent. Here author is saying, once the best search agent is defined, other will update their position toward the best. So once the best search agent is defined, other search agents will update their position toward the best search agent. As you can see here, we will assume the current optimal solution as prey. So that's why once this is defined, other will update their position toward the best one. Here we are using this mathematical model for encircling. Here this is the distance vector that we will use to calculate the distance, and here this is the position vector, and here this is the best solution obtained. Now in this method we will check the value. If this value is less than 1, it means agent approaches to the current optimal solution. If value of A is less than 1, it means the agent approaches to the current optimal solution. So we will calculate the distance between the whale and the prey using these mathematical models. You can calculate the distance and update the position. So first step is initialize the population. So first we will initialize the population randomly and other parameters. Suppose we have here 5 search agents, so we will initialize the population randomly for 5 search agents. As you can see here, I initialized the population of 5 search agents randomly. Now, in order to compute the fitness value, we will use a fitness function. In the research paper, you can check the research paper written by Sir Miraj Ali and Lewis. The fitness function number 16, that is this one. Using this function, I computed the fitness value. Here you can see we have, this is values for x1, values for x2. Put these values in this fitness function, and you can see we have the fitness values for each search agent. Now among all, we will check the optimal value, that is the optimized value, minimum one. And you can see here, this is the minimum value. So this is the simple algorithm. You can see the steps. First, we will initialize the population for n search agent. Here n is the value, that is the number of search agents. After that, we will compute the fitness value for each search agent. After this, we will choose the best search agent. check the condition. If this is true, then we will update the certain parameters. And then here p is the random value. Check this condition. If condition is true, we will select an agent and update this position using this equation. If this condition is true, then we will update the agent position using this mathematical model. After updating the position of the search agents, again using the fitness function, we will update the fitness value for each agent, and we will find the optimal solution. Again, increment the counter until this condition is false. We will repeat this loop. When this condition is satisfied, we will return the best search agent and its fitness value. So this is the simple algorithm, and this algorithm is similar to Gray Wolf optimization algorithm. This is almost similar to this algorithm. You can check this algorithm also. In next video, we will see this algorithm with an example and MATLAB code. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.